They say I'm crazy, the way you got me open, baby. Ooh. They say I'm bugging, the way I'm time sweating your loving. Ooh. They all sit and wonder why this feeling I cannot hide. It ain't a question of pride. Ooh. It's love. It's love. It's love. It's love. It's love. It's love. They say I'm flipping the way you got my whole life flipping. Ooh. They say
hey, 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 it's Taylor Love of Taylor Love Tells All Love's Tragic Comedy Show. And today, happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
It's our debut of Venus Meets Mars with Mr. Mica and author Tracy Jackson. And you know, my co-host and my bestie, Wanda. So we're going to get started on Valentine's Day, but first I want Mr. Tracy, if he could put his damn beer down, to pop the cork so Wanda and I can have some damn champagne and we can make a cheers. So how's everybody doing today on Valentine's Day?
I am great. I'm doing fabulous. It's a wonderful cold day here in the DMV.
Mm-hmm. I'm good. Everything is good.
All right, Mr. Mica.
Can't complain. Everything's all right. Happy Valentine's Day to everybody.
Indeed, all right, indeed. Let's start off with the bullshit. What?
Damn.
Before
I'm
we
show my eyes for the bullshit.
For the bullshit.
Before we went on air, Tracy was talking about how people want damn Valentine's Day to be some kind of damn holiday. So
that's not what he said.
He said okay.
He said like a national holiday. Don't take my man's words and try to spin it around. He said a national. People wanted today off and you're like, what the fuck?
What are you talking about?
Right.
It's not that big of a deal, people. But enjoy.
For some it might be. It might be.
Okay.
Just not to
who's in love at this table here?
In love?
Yeah, L-O-V-E. This is the Tale of Love show. I love Wanda and my family. Okay, I don't have a man that I'm in love with.
Hey, I'm gonna tell y'all right now. I'm in love. It's white, and it does me all day long. My PlayStation 4.
Wow, and you always win on that game, I bet.
Yeah, okay. When he said it's white, I'm like, wait
yeah,
a minute.
Yeah. I was like, okay.
Tracy, give me that damn bottle.
I don't want it. It's cool.
But anyway, my point about if you're in love, love yourself.
Okay. No, it's not coming out. Go ahead.
They're fighting over the bottle right here. Who's going to pop it? Give it here. I'm a pro with popping.
I got this, boo. Oh, bam.
Shit.
There
did
we
that
go.
Hit you? Get in shorts.
Right.
Okay, the party's getting ready to start now. Right. Be kicking off. It's Valentine's segment, Venus Meets Mars on the Taylor Love Tales All Show.
Y'all get beer, we get champagne. Is that okay?
I had no problem with that.
And let me just give you guys who are viewing a little background and the premise behind this show. Tracy and Mr. Mica came on the show December 6th, and it was called From a Man's Perspective. And a lot of our female viewers wanted to hear what men had to say about relationships and love and those kind of things. So that's how this puppy was born. This is not based on the book, Women Are From Venus, Men Are From Mars, although there are some similarities in terms of how we communicate towards each other. And we say the same things, but we may interpret it like Mr. Micah just said, because I said something, Tracy, and he translated it. So anyway.
Right. Totally different.
Here we are today. Different. So, let's get started. Valentine's Day gifts. Well, Tracy, you know, do you disappear on Valentine's Day?
No. I don't have a problem with Valentine's Day. And if the person that I'm dating or the person I'm with wants gifts or wants to celebrate Valentine's Day, I don't have a problem with that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's, you know, the old cliche thing. Some people say, well, I do for you all the time. Well, right. One certain day. That's okay. But I'm saying, if the person I'm with wants something on Valentine's Day, they want to celebrate it, then that's cool, but it's no big deal. If nobody gives me a card or candy on Valentine's Day.
Yeah, right. Whatever.
Your feelings going to be hurt, I'm sure.
I'm not a big gift person on anything.
Okay.
You know, you acknowledge it. You come in the house and say, hey, happy Valentine's Day. Thank you. We can keep on going.
Well, it's not that simple for me. When I was in relationships, I got wonderful gifts, flowers, diamonds, jewelry. I am all about the gifts, and I'm not a material girl, but I do like somebody to go out and think about me, get that right nice gift that I was asking for two weeks, a week before, and usually I get it. I like going to dinner. I like all that kind of romantic stuff, so I'm sorry, but, you know.
That's how she likes it.
Just on that day.
No, Christmas too. My birthday. Especially
birthday.
So, okay. Yeah. Valentine's Day, though, that's a big, big headache, because everybody and their mom is all trying to get a spot at a restaurant.
Just
because you plan in advance,
why can't you do it
another
day? Why does it have to be that day? Who actually started this day?
Cupid. Right? I don't know who started it, but you know, hey,
get y'all more gifts. Right.
Well, you know,
birthday, Christmas, I agree.
Now you could be home by the fireplace. If he cooks, you can have a nice dinner or takeout. I didn't say you have to go to a restaurant. It's all about the imagination and things you can do together. I mean, hey.
So if he gave you some shaky things.
What shaky things?
Vibrators.
Some bullshit. Oh.
Vibrators.
I mean, well, I should already have that. I mean,
upgrade.
Oh, yeah, well, new shit.
Some 50 Shades of Grey shit.
I never got that yet. Right. So, but okay.
Okay, so what is your take?
My thing is, I feel it's too commercial. But since it's here, I want mine too. But I don't want the standard CVS candy and teddy bear and flowers. I want a person that knows me well enough to know this is something special. It doesn't have to be big or grand, but I want them to take time to say this is something that she would really like and appreciate.
I'm saying, okay, so let me ask you this. So that's what you want. You want this, you want that. It's Valentine's Day. Right. Now, is Valentine's Day just for the women?
No, I think it should be for the men too.
Okay, so now if I wanted to, it's All-Star Weekend, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Basketball stuff is going to be on all day. So for Valentine's Day, I wanted to just, let's chill home. I want to watch some games. Is that all right?
That's all right.
But it can't be both.
I'm a sports
y'all wanna
girl.
If you want to go all the romantic stuff and this and that, you can't be romantic watching basketball.
We can be romantic at a certain point.
You can turn on the game with some candy like fool.
No,
under the blankets. I have my jersey shirt on and my booty shorts.
Well, halftime, we got our own show popping.
But my point in that is
pom poms.
It's compromise.
No, it's not compromise. Valentine's Day. Let's be real. It's for women.
It's for the women.
Flowers. Now, I'm not saying men can't get flowers, but it's about the flowers and the candy and the romantic dinners.
Victoria's Secret.
Like, you don't see the women.
How would you feel if somebody sent you flowers?
I would not mind it at all. I've had it happen before, but I wouldn't mind it at all.
Okay. How about you?
No, I wouldn't mind. But some guys might have a problem with that. I just wanted to ask.
Would
you send your man flowers?
I haven't done that.
I would if he was a flower receiving kind of guy. That's right. Why I say you got to know your mate in order to get, you know.
I never even thought about sending him flowers.
Oh, okay, but you want your diamonds. All right. Yeah, but she want her diamonds and furs. Right.
Match a belly.
But I never thought about sending a man.
He can't get them from the $5.
Okay.
Would you send him anything?
Oh yeah, he gets whatever. If he asks for something, I'll try to get it.
What about just out of there's a problem. You wouldn't send a man flowers just out of the blue.
No, I've never done it. Now I'm not saying I can't, but I've never thought to say, "Oh, I'm gonna send him some flowers."
Sent a man flowers either, but I'm not opposed to it. So
yeah, I mean,
but it's just really Valentine's Day. The people that get shit like at work get on my nerves because then they run around. Oh look, and then it's always the people like me who ain't getting.
But that's what it is.
Yeah,
that's what
I'm mad as hell.
They don't want to be left out. They want to show everyone in the office somebody loves me, and that's what it's really about.
Yeah,
you can. I swear to my hand to God, if they received some flowers from an error, it was the wrong person, right? They would still run around the office and wouldn't tell a damn soul. Like, it was meant for Lucy, but she picked them up. Like, this ain't Lucy, but
hey. Oh, I got some flowers. Right. You know, there are people that buy their own shit and get it sent to them.
That too.
I may have to do that next time.
Then you start being crazy.
After saying all of that, what we just said, So what's the big deal about Valentine's Day then?
There is no big deal except for now I'm sucked up into the vortex.
If you know it's all this, why would it bother you if somebody not give it to you? But that's what I'm saying. If you know it's all this, why would it bother you if you don't get anything?
Because when I was in a relationship, if I didn't get anything, I thought that the guy should say, this is important to her. Forget how I feel and make her feel good.
Okay, so y'all remember when we had the conversation last time we were here, we were saying, is there a conversation when it becomes a relationship, right? This is one of those things that are in that initial conversation.
Valentine's Day.
Yeah, holidays, period. Is your birthday a big deal? Is Valentine's Day a big deal? Because for me, my birthday is not a big deal, and I don't do Valentine's Day. But that's something I would have to discuss with somebody if I was in a relationship with them and say, hey, is this a big deal? And if it is, like you said, you have to recognize. You got to play that game and go ahead and buy whatever it is you need to buy.
I say this. You can ask a woman, is this a big deal? Is that a big deal? Regardless if they say no, you still got to get them something.
Right.
We know that. You still got to get them. You don't have to make a big deal about it.
I disagree.
But you got to give. I found that you have to get them something. Now, I'm not saying you can't say all or none. So you're going to have some who say it's no big deal and it's no big deal.
The point is you got to find somebody who's being true. They're not playing the damn game.
There you go. Right. Right.
Who's like, no, I don't want anything. And in the back of their head, this motherfucker better bring me something.
Exactly. And that's what I'm saying.
That's right.
But see, the funny thing is you have people or you have guys who they might do things with their lady all the time. They always going. They always having a good time. They always doing for them. And then on Valentine's Day, if he doesn't get her that one thing that she wanted for Valentine's Day, there's a problem. That makes no sense to me.
Yeah, but that's all part of the game.
But that makes no sense to me.
The whole game is done.
Well.
But she said she wanted it.
But I'm
asking. I have been fortunate. I mean, I'm not in a relationship now. I don't have anything, a card, nothing. It's okay. Mm-hmm. But if I am in a relationship and when I was in a relationship, pretty much the guys who was with me, I mean, they gave me stuff and they did it like they're supposed to. The flowers, the dinner, the candy. I mean, hey.
Right.
Well, I mean, they did.
Here's the next question, and it goes along with other holidays as well.
So
but
I'm sorry.
Is there a problem when your gifts don't match?
What you mean don't match?
Underwear.
Wait. He spent $100 and you spent $10.
$100.
He gave you some flowers, candy, and a little charm bracelet, and you got him floor seats at the Wizard game. And something like that. And then now you spent $500.
No, but
$2.
I'm going with
issue?
Them to the floor seats to the Wizards game. Okay. So that's because I want to get the good tickets because I'm there. But it depends. We know the person. We know their position pretty much. Okay. So if I'm able to do more things, then it's okay that we're good together. But he better go get a second job some damn way to catch up. No, I'm just...
I'm not buying that.
What is that bullshit?
I need a yellow flag. Penalty on the flag.
Which pretty much that, but pretty much the African American women are dating guys that are not on their level financially.
What the fuck?
I know. Didn't I go there?
I don't know how we got there, but okay.
Because you said that the gifts didn't match.
But, wait a minute. But I'm no, about to what break you were
he about to throw the damn bell. Okay.
Well,
that's you're saying that if he can't do this or his money isn't like that, that's bullshit. Because you know what you're gonna be saying? Well, you knew Valentine's Day was coming.
You should have
been
saving
for it. It's the same time every year. So you should have, okay. But you're saying now, if I know he's has this problem, that's bullshit.
No, I'm saying it's bullshit because she's saying most African American men are not making dollars.
I'm not addressing that. That's another show.
That's another Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, let's mark that down.
Make that a topic.
Okay.
But, he knew it was coming. Valentine's Day is the same time every year, which it is. So if your money is not right to get him this, oh, I'll understand that. No, you won't. Because, like we were saying, it's all about what you present to everybody else. You be with your lady. Oh, we went here. We went to dinner here. And, you know, this place, right. That place. What did you guys do? Oh, well, he bought me a box of candy, and we just stayed home, watched TV.
Yeah.
And then you upset. You wasn't upset when you got the box of candy because you knew what his money could do this year.
But his money wasn't long.
Now I'm all hyped up on the candy, and I want to go somewhere.
Get your EBT card out, boo, and get some damn crab legs.
Okay, yeah. Suck on that.
Now,
damn, she's a suck on that.
Ooh, wee. But, you know, and Valentine's Day, when I was doing my research about it, a lot of people suffer from depression on this particular day. But, I mean, I can't. Me too.
It solidifies at this point. If you don't have a significant other, it solidifies it.
That you're some single, women, you're alone.
You like, oh, this is that point where I'm now a spinster. Or you know, they start thinking. Yeah.
Did he say spinster?
They start thinking that. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't.
Or if you with somebody and he doesn't acknowledge you.
Well, that means or you're that he's the got other somebody
side
else.
Piece. Right. We're going to talk about that side
piece.
That
just means your Valentine's Day is February the 15th.
Right. Or the 13th.
Side piece day.
Friday the 13th.
If he took you to lunch right at noon for Valentine's Day and then you ain't hear from him the rest of the night, you was the side piece. So that's another
now
thing
you're
y'all
depressed.
Got. Y'all gotta, gotta know.
Whitney Houston song. What's that?
What?
Whitney Houston song with the man. She's waiting for him.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I can't think of the name of the song.
Anyway, you my song.
Yeah,
girl,
he took you
song.
To Denny's at 4 in the morning. this is our dinner.
Did you at 6 and then say, I'll be back, and then she'll come back up.
You was the side piece on Valentine's Day. As long as you good with it, though, I'm good with it.
You waiting for that coffee, you okay?
Right.
Oh, Starbucks. Cell phone goes straight to voicemail. It's awful, but. You know, each year, well, now, like I said, now that I'm not in a relationship, it doesn't bother me. I don't care. Wanda gave me something on Valentine's Day, so thank you, boo. And she's old, gives considerate gifts.
I'm going to tell y'all something else you might not have known. And what? This isn't everybody, but this is a few, select few. After today, there's going to be a whole lot more men willing to be in relationships.
Why?
Because
they wait.
Yep. It's a lot of guys that wait. It's a triangle. They wait for Christmas, New Year's, and Valentine's Day to pass before they get it because they don't want to buy the gifts. And spend time.
And they break
now
up.
It's good. We good. Yeah, right?
The gates open up tomorrow.
Like, damn it, her birthday is February 21st.
Right, until May, and then you're gone again because summer's going to be back. So,
oh, yeah.
So mm-hmm. if he says he buns you up summer. Right now, then you got a short term coming.
Oh, my God. Well. So all I can say
keep it real.
Happy Valentine's Day to those of you who are out there. And then, you know, they are the seniors, I guess. They've been together for 30, 40 years. What the hell are they doing on Valentine's Day?
They not playing the game. If they've been together for 30, 40
like,
years,
get the fuck off
they
me,
know,
Joe.
They know we're not going out today, baby, because there's too many folks out there. We're going to go and sit in the house and do what we normally do and have ourselves a good time.
TV dinner, looking at the
TV. Hey, if that's what floats your boat, then, you know, to each his own. Yeah.
It's going to be a special day for them.
Yeah, I mean,
they're gonna get the special stuff today. That's when they get older.
See,
I'm
about to say those people.
Get some special sex. You know, they call special.
Their eyes are open.
But see, this was right with them.
His leg is up.
He's gonna wait till tomorrow and go to CVS and get the $30 box of chocolate for $14 or $7.
Oh yeah,
because
it got the big 50% off sign on it.
Oh my side chick specials the day after on sale.
But that's what's gonna happen. I mean, but I'm okay. This is the last time I'm saying it. I don't have a problem with Valentine's Day. I'm not opposed to it. I just think it's some people make way too much of it. And like Ira said, it's not because of their relationship between them two. It's because what other people are gonna look and see. If he didn't get you this, he didn't get you
right,
that.
Right.
Then they're gonna be chiming in about what you know most. Most guys don't worry about that. If Mr. Mica said for his birthday he got this from his lady, I'm not going to be like, that's all you got?
Right.
Really? Yeah. Well, my lady, when my birthday came, she did this, that, and the third. Most guys don't do that. Women, on the other hand, they're going to say something like that. And I might give you something for Valentine's Day, and you might be happy with it, fine. And then you come home the next day, oh, well, Wanda went here, went there. And then you got to ask you, what's wrong? We don't never go nowhere like that. It's
ridiculous.
It's always a show. But again, if that's my lady and she wants something or she wants to do stuff for Valentine's, I have no problem with doing it. I just don't think it should be that big of a deal.
Okay.
That's just my opinion.
I semi agree. Because I'm single. When I get in a relationship, my whole attitude about this is going to change.
You know that bullshit I said last Valentine's
Day? Don't listen to that shit. You better bring me something. Right.
I already put mine out there.
Yeah, right.
So, I mean, in terms of love, though, and I know, are you guys affectionate kind of guys? Or y'all kind of, are y'all cuddly?
I can be. What's your natural instinct? I mean, it depends on the person. It depends on the relationship. I mean, just because you might be this way with one person and this way with someone else.
I guess my real question is, how do you show your significant other that you love them?
Five languages of love. You're going back to that.
Okay.
Right? Mine.
Five languages?
Yeah, there was a book that was out, and it said that people express their language of love in five different ways.
Really, Mr. Mica? Tell us about it, please.
You motherfucker.
That's one. I think I've been there.
And I don't remember verbatim, but it was like, it was gifts. It was like money spent, time spent, affection. And
think communications in there?
It might have been. It was two others, but I know for me, mine is time spent and gifts. I mm-hmm. like to show them with gifts when it's that time. So that's my language.
And sex got to be in there as a language.
But that's a gift.
It was physical. Yeah. It was physical. Was one of them. And sex is.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're talking about cutting. I mean, I have no problem with, you know, the touching and the cuddling. I mean, that's fine.
Spooning.
That's fine. I mean, that's fine.
Not too long, though.
Not too long. What is too long?
I don't know.
Till you fall asleep?
When it gets hot.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We can have two rooms now. You know, hey.
So, but yeah, I mean, yeah, I think everybody, when they're with that person, they do the cuddling and the touching and the kissing. I think that's everybody. I don't think they're...
But it fades, though, kind of.
I don't think it's everybody.
I don't think it's everybody. Because no. I've been with some guys that don't want not touchy feely. Right. It could be.
That's what I'm saying. When it is that person.
Because I can be overly affectionate. And it could have been that. I could be like, damn, can you just let me breathe for 10
well,
minutes?
Well, like I say, if it's not an equal thing, if this person doesn't feel as strongly about you as you feel about them, it's going to seem like that. You know, there's going to be that time you might want to hold their hand and touch them, and they might be like, this motherfucker, yeah. Yep. But then it might be a time when you both want each other, like, mm-hmm. you know, it's the equal thing. So sometimes it's not about they're not that affectionate. It just could be he's just not that into you.
Well,
I was just thinking that.
Is that why that chick kiss me?
Yeah. But usually when I have a connection with somebody, I go with like a chemistry kind of thing. So if I'm like drawn to you and I sit close to you and I feel comfortable stretching out, put my feet across your lap while we're watching TV and all that kind of stuff, I already pretty much know that.
You do that during the show. Okay.
I'm going to try this one. You won't even see me. But yeah, I'm pretty much touchy-feely. Yeah,
me too. Yeah, so. I just wanted to get a man's perspective on it.
I've been in relationships where the other person was more affectionate than I was, but... Mm-hmm. I mean,
and that's hard too.
It's not hard. It's just it's you hard not knowing where they're coming from. Well, it's not like I'm like telling them to get away from me.
You don't like me? What is it? And they look at it like themselves.
I just realized that they're more affectionate than me, and they want to kiss, and they want to hug, cuddle, and you know, you accommodate it as much as you can.
That's but you're such a big teddy bear. I mean, you know, it's irresistible, Mica. Okay.
Teddy bears are fat. Hold on, I got to
okay. Oh, my God. But, you know, as there are people out there today that are going through the motions. Tomorrow they'll be broken up. There are people out there who broke up yesterday or last week.
Then they get back together just for
Valentine's. They broke up Monday. They didn't want to sing.
Right, too obvious. Right.
They broke up Monday.
But then they get back together today, kind of reminiscing.
No, tomorrow.
By Wednesday.
Wednesday.
By Wednesday.
When they come back.
They'll call you and say, let's go out to eat.
That's what the players man. Yeah. Wednesday. That's okay. Good.
And so should she take them back?
She will.
She will.
She will. Oh, wow.
Will. Why? I mean, because she knows. Let me tell you something. If that happens, she knows. She knows what's going on.
She knows. She knows. She knows. That's
Neo's
new song. Go ahead.
All right. But that's what happens. I mean, it happens all the time.
Yeah, you're right. We tend to sometimes act like we do know. It's innate, right? Yeah. And we're like, oh, this motherfucker.
You just don't
want
to believe it.
I don't play games. I wouldn't go. If you broke up with me on Monday, I'm not going out with you on Wednesday after Valentine's Day. You should have been here on Valentine's Day.
So, in the history of your relationship,
so when are you going out? So when are you going to go back out with me? When are you going to go back out with me?
I don't. We could. Hey, how you doing? But I'm not going back. I don't backtrack.
Okay.
You
thinking about something?
You've never been gone back with somebody you were with before and y'all broke up?
Okay.
Prove my point. I said one in the time, history of you dating,
once I went back, it was that one time, and I was like, OMG, and the other, this is why, and we didn't do it again.
The other thing is, and too, this is not a slight or anything, but just math. Right now, I mean, men are scarce.
What?
It's a whole lot of y'all.
Yeah.
A lot less of us.
Yeah.
So... if he's a halfway decent guy and he was just a jerk about that, she probably is going to take him back.
Yeah, we'll try to fix you.
Yeah.
We'll try to fix
you. I might at least sleep with you.
Right. I've heard that before.
Yeah, I might not be in a relationship with you. Yeah,
and then that's going to lead back.
You think that's a problem for him? I mean,
no, it's not. Okay, so. I'm not punishing him. Okay. Because I already know. Like you said, we go into it. We pretty much know. You disappear on the weekend or Valentine's Day. We know. I mean, this has been going on for hundreds of years.
Right.
And so, I'm not, if I'm going to sleep with you, it's no punishment. Because we already know. If I take you back and I do it to you, then why would you change?
She said do it to you.
And it's, do it to you. Have sex
till I'm satisfied.
So, I mean, I'm not going to try and punish you because the punishment is when I don't see you anymore at all. That's your punishment. Not for me to take you back and have sex with you and then kick you out because that's what you wanted anyway.
And we know it.
Mm-hmm. Well, everybody wins on that, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, if the sex is good.
Yeah. And go to bed. And like, oh, I can sleep good. He's gone. I ain't got to worry about putting him out in the morning and shit. Okay.
So, win-win situation.
So.
Okay.
What are some tips for the single people out here?
Mm-hmm.
It depends on what gender we're speaking now. Because the tips are different.
Okay.
Now, I saw someone post a guy post on Facebook, you know, and he was saying that he was lonely, you know, he didn't have nobody for Valentine's Day. And I was out yesterday having dinner by myself, enjoyed my grilled fish and everything, my margaritas. And I'm like, well, love yourself.
I mean, if you don't have anybody, just go out and do that.
Yeah.
That was 2 minutes before he got on Facebook, and now he's depressed. Yeah. All his manhood went to napkin.
Right, the testosterone is gone. Yeah, that's weird. I appreciate his honesty. I mean, I can't really knock him, but that's weird to me.
But I know it's normal for women to say, oh, I'm depressed, I don't have anybody. But now I see kind of men kind of going there.
Well, I think that, for the majority, most people want to be with somebody. Most people want somebody else. Mm-hmm. But there you have to, some people enjoy being single.
I hear you, Raleigh.
Me too. I enjoy being single. All right, we got a caller. Hello, you're on the Taylor Love Show.
It's Raleigh, North Carolina calling.
Hey, Raleigh! Happy Valentine's Day!
Thank you. I have a tip for the single people.
All right, what's the tip?
How big
stay
is it?
Stay single!
Yes, amen to that!
Stay single.
Right, I agree with
I
that.
I like to mingle. Well, you know, that's supposed to
be. So you, what are you doing today on Valentine's Day?
Oh, I'm just not answering the calls from the four old boyfriends trying to get back.
Four?
Oh, shit. All right, well, send two of the calls this way. Four of them to my number.
Goodbye.
Bye, darling.
Well, she said four. I mean, our milkshake brings people. All the boys to
y'all. Wait a minute. I mean, some people like being single.
I enjoy it.
Yeah, but even those that like to be single still like to have companionship when they want it.
I agree.
They don't want it around all the time, but I guarantee you every now and then they want somebody to come
over.
Yeah, it'd
be nice to.
Right. Well, for the most part, when I'm single, I still have a nice time. I still go out and date and everything. Just because you're single don't mean you're not dating and things like that. And there's a difference between being, you know, if you're a single person and being alone and being lonely.
Right.
There's a big difference. I don't know if I've ever really been lonely.
Me neither.
I've been single and when being single, you can date. You can go out and have a good time. I can go out and have a good time with someone that I'm not attracted to at all.
Mm-hmm.
And just fine.
That's my best time.
Just enjoying the company of a woman is fine. So being single is not that bad. Now, if you want to be with somebody, then you know you. I'm not saying go out there and search for them person.
I was gonna say, are we trolling the bars?
To each his own. I mean, some people, that's their thing.
You know, because some will go to the singles things at church and meet somebody,
and that's all right too. But you touched on something, and I'm gonna say this is a tip to ladies, right? Be open and receptive, right? Even if a guy is not your type, right? At first glance, you may look at him and say, I don't know. But just be open to it. For example, a lot of people I encounter women at work. I like to compliment women. I may sit in the company. I like to be in the company of women, and I'm not even trying to get at you anything, get your number. I just want to sit there and talk to you. See, you know, and they automatically assume I got a man, baby. All I said was you look nice today. That's all. All you had to do was say thank you and keep it moving. Mm-hmm. So just be open and receptive to see, you know, just talk to people. And who knows what'll happen?
Well, yeah, I'm like that. I talk to anybody.
Yeah,
and
she does.
Cross that bridge when it comes. When he asks you for your number, or can you go out? Then that's when you say, oh, I'm sorry, I have somebody, or no, thank you.
Yeah.
Don't assume.
Right. That's what he's trying to get at.
I can't stand that. Now you look ugly.
Yeah, I never assume. I mean,
and then you know I sort of like the same way. I'll talk to a guy. He'll come up and have a conversation, and then when
she shuts him down,
you're
not going far. That's
because
for sure.
I just know myself is like, I don't want to talk on the phone. I don't want to be texting. So I at least know myself well enough to know what I don't want.
Okay, well, let me say this about that. What you say? You don't want to talk on the phone. You don't want to text. Okay, you don't want that. Until you find the guy that you want that with.
Yes,
but that's,
okay.
But how that's are you going to, you know what I'm saying?
So duplicit. How am I going to know?
You're being duplicit with that. Because
you want it when you want it.
Right.
You know, and this guy, you never know if you gave this guy a chance, he might be the one. Now, I'm not saying that every guy that comes to you, you got to do that. Because I understand that sometimes I'm not a big phone person.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not. But, you know, I would give that chance. I'll talk to you on the phone for a while. I'll let you know right up front too. Hey, I'm not a big phone person. So you can understand that if I am on the phone talking to you tonight and tomorrow, then I'm doing that because of you.
Right.
You know, so, but, you know, you say people, women, men, they say, oh, I don't want this, I don't want that. Yes, you do. You don't want it from
that particular person.
But you want it from him. And since he's not giving it to you, you don't want it from anybody, but you want it from him.
But then that goes back to chemistry. Because when I'm having a conversation, when I just meet you, I'm like, you know, but that could be the wrong person. I agree. He could be a knucklehead from God knows where. And then the nice, well, not the nice guy, because they both could be nice guys. And then the other guy that I didn't give a chance to, that I didn't really have chemistry with, I missed that opportunity. So mentally, I know this.
I think that's what he's saying. If we're at the bar and you come and sit down beside me, I start a conversation with you. I'm not trying to get at you or anything. We're just at the bar having drinks, so I'm going to make my night enjoyable. I'm going to talk to you.
Right.
We're going to laugh and joke. And then you know what? You're going to get up and get ready to leave, and you're going to probably be thinking, he's about to ask me for my number. I don't want it. And I'm going to be like, have a nice evening.
Or
nice
I might be saying, I hope he asked me for my number.
Well, why not give him your number?
Wait, why are you hoping?
See, give me your number. See, that's what I'm saying.
That's a game.
You don't need to do that. You just... I can go around. I can go to the bar alone, sit down, order a drink. If someone sits beside me, how you doing? Just talking. I'll buy you a drink. We can have it. And then at the end of the evening, I might get up and say, you know what? It was nice talking to you. I hope I see you here again. And be on my way out the door. And I had a good time. I didn't try to get at you. I didn't try to pick you up. If you're interested, then you can say something.
And when you walk up, a lot of times I see the wedding ring on the finger. Right, I know you're married.
Exactly.
You might be there by yourself, and I'm like, hey, you want just company. You know what I mean? I'm not trying to bust up your home. I just want to get there.
You bust up the home. I'm trying to take your drama.
And the other thing is, too, you might sit there and talk to Tracy, right? And he may not be your cup of tea. But maybe the person that's meant for you is through Tracy.
Right.
Ooh.
You know, networking. Because you were open, and you talked, and y'all hit it off. You're like, hey, we can chit-chat sometime.
Do y'all do that?
I'll take a people's number.
Like, if you got a friend... I'm putting my business. You got a friend, and he said, you know what? I don't really see guys introducing women to friends like that.
Yeah, they
do?
Yeah.
Okay, well, y'all think about me, you know, nice guy. don't put in your mind the presence too much. That's my department. Look, I get it.
But see, no, I'm glad you said that, though.
I don't know any nice guys.
But I'm glad you said that, because I know if I know that and I'm going to introduce you to Mr. Mike, I might be like, nah, he ain't going to that bullshit. So I won't do that. That might be the person I won't, because I'm not going to.
That could be a change for Mr. Mike, and he might. Then you'd be like, damn.
If I know my man.
See, my thing is, I put him together. You know, some people are just absolutely wrong for each other.
Exactly. So I wouldn't do that.
That's what you're saying about that. That wouldn't be something that I would. That's something y'all have to work out. If I thought your personalities would click, I'm like, okay, the gift thing, they can work out on their own.
Right.
But have you ever introduced?
I had a female friend of mine just ask me if I had any guy friends to hook her up with. And right now, I really don't. That's how I know I'm getting older, because most of my friends are in relationships. Mm-hmm. In committed relationships. So that's a sign you're getting older.
Smaller.
It's the middle part. It's the young part, middle part, and then I think more the older people kind of
seasoned.
We're the single. You know, I mean, I've never really dated anybody too much older than me. If it wasn't my age on down, I never really did the older.
I've never had one person older than me, not even by a year.
Yeah. Well, I
prefer it
older.
Yeah. I'm hoping they teach me something.
Oh, sure. We hope they teach you too.
So what else can we discuss that y'all guys want to share with us? What are we going to be doing in the future?
You said tips. Well, first of all, tips too. Also, women, stop being so damn thirsty. Just let it go.
I'm thirsty now. Can I get another glass?
Who wanted some more wine?
Just let it go. Yeah. I mean, if it's meant to be, you showing up at his desk.
What?
You might work with him like eight times a day. You putting yourself in his vicinity. If he wanted you, boo, he would have did it like five scenarios ago.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Stop. Just let it flow. Whatever's going to happen is going to happen. If it's meant to be, it's meant to be.
Right. Yeah.
Usually, if I see an attractive lady somewhere, right, I won't approach her on the first time. I always tell myself, if it's meant for me to be with her, I'll see her again. And then the second time, then I'll say something.
You get her.
Yeah, pounce on her like a tiger. Like a tiger. Tiger.
Oh, my goodness.
So stop being so thirsty. Let it flow.
Okay. I'll say this. I have tips for women and men. Women, stop the games. It's just a lot of games. You play the game. I was talking to someone, and, you know, women have... Just like we did earlier, I said something, mm-hmm. You said what you heard. You didn't say what I said, you said what you heard.
Right.
And that's a big difference in men and women. I will say something, and you'll take it, a woman will take it one way. If you don't understand what I said, ask me.
But I'm thinking I understood what you said.
No, you know you didn't understand. You know you heard what you wanted to hear. If you have a problem with anything I said, ask me again. Okay. Let me explain it to you. Don't just say in your mind, well... I just thought you meant no. If you have to say I thought you meant, then you need to ask me.
Okay.
Ask me again so I can tell you what I meant.
Mm-hmm.
And guys, it's some good girls out here because they dealt with some cans, corny ass niggas.
What's the can?
They will accept anything. So guys, some guys play on that. So
when
you meet a good girl, when you meet somebody that's a decent woman, come on, treat them as such.
Treat them like a lady.
So
yeah, chivalry is not dead, fellas. No, so you have to do those things.
It's some good guys. Man, it's some good guys. I know a lot of good guys. And just as some girls have been turned because of bad guys they dealt with, sometimes guys just say, man, I'm tired of this boy. Because you deal with these ladies who they have all these other... Okay, I understand you've had problems in the past. Tracy might have dogged you this way. So when Mr. Mica comes along, he's trying to be a good guy. You don't want to give him a chance because of what you had in the past. So you're going to run Mr. Mica off. Because you're not giving him a chance. So you got to stop that.
Yes, sir. We'll stop that. Yes, Now, I just want to let you guys know, Venus Meets Mars is going to air every second Saturday of the month here on Listen Vision Live. Please submit your questions. Give us a call. Contact us. Tracy, give everybody your website address. So if they want to contact you, they can hit you up.
Well, they can hit me up through your Facebook page, one. And then I also have my own website, which is wordswriting.com. And you can hit me. I'm on Facebook, Tracy Jackson. Let's see where else.
I don't have the
Twitter or all that other stuff. I just don't do all that stuff.
And Mr. Mica, I'm sorry, baby.
No, that's fine, that's fine.
Mr. Mica, would you like to share your email address or your Facebook page?
I'm actually on IG. You can reach me at ask_Mr. Mica, and that's pretty much it for me. I have a Twitter account. Just getting it up. So next time I'm on, I'll have that set up and ready. But right now, just IG, ask Mr. Mica. It's ask_Mr. Mica.
And Wanda, we know where to find you.
You know where to find me. Here, tell a love tales all.
And so what we're going to do is, like I said, every Saturday, we're going to talk about topics related to men, women. We can do pop culture. We can do whatever you guys are interested in. We're going to talk about it. We're going to get a man's perspective. We're going to get a female's perspective. Venus is going to meet Mars. We got some exciting things we hope to be coming up, some vignette writing. We're going to do some episodes and hopefully show them on the show as well. Am I leaving anything out, fellas?
Just
have any questions, just submit them.
Book's coming.
Uh-oh, tell us about it.
Oh, well...
If you want to.
Well, no, it's just that I got working on first full novel. You've got some writing you said you would try to do.
Yes.
But I've got a first full novel trying to get that. I'm in the last stages of the editing process, so we're working on that. Have the two that's out already. Like I said, if you go to Words Writing, you can look for those. Like I said, we're working on the, what'd you say?
Vignettes.
Okay.
Vignettes.
Okay.
I'm trying to think of another word. What's the other word for it?
More events coming.
Yeah, exactly. Wanda, cut us off. Thank you, Wanda.
Just look for more coming.
Yeah. So, and I'm excited to have you guys here, and welcome again, and thank you for participating.
We can't emphasize enough. If you have any questions, just submit them to any one of us, and then we'll pose the question on air and answer them for you.
Mm-hmm. So this concludes our Venus Meets Mars, and I want everybody to have a happy Valentine's Day. Love you guys. So, Mike, if you could do Let's Talk logo and Rufus and Chaka Khan take us to break, and we'll be right back. Love Tells All Love's Tragic Comedy Show.
Yeah, and it's Let's Talk with Wanda. I am so hot after that Venus Meets Mars. I feel like I'm on Pluto, Saturn, or something. Please cool me off. That was something. So I'm looking forward to seeing us do this every second Saturday of the month.
Right,
so
right.
Tune in, everyone. Venus Meets Mars is coming up. But let's talk about what's going on this week. Obama health care. Now, if you don't have health care, you better go online by today, or you know, after at least by tomorrow. I think midnight tomorrow is over with, February 15th. Get your health care, people. Then the ones out there walking the street say, I don't need health care.
Look at Rocky. What the guy I'm talking? He's looking at her like, my mommy.
She's a star. And, you know, get your health care, people, so you can get those checkups, get your heart check, your diabetes, your damn blood pressure. So next year, you'll be more ready for Valentine's to put it down like you should, okay?
I can get my tooth fixed.
Yeah, get your teeth done and all that. So health care, health care.
Health care.
February 15th. Now, I don't know if you remember, about 2 weeks ago, we did the State of the Union, and we talked about that little Judge Ginsburg and how she was dozing off during the State of the Union speech with President Obama. Well, comes to find out, she had two glasses of wine prior to the State of the Union. Cheers to you, Judge Ginsburg. And her little ass fell asleep. That's what she said. I still think she's too damn old to be on the bench, okay? Time is up. You can stay home, retire, collect your money.
Drink all the hell you want.
That's right. Get all that good wine from France, Italy, or wherever. So, you know, just let somebody younger get in that seat so we can get some new laws.
She got a flask under her robe on the bench.
I would, too. Hopefully she got some granny drawers on the under that robe, too.
Granny panties.
Okay, not a thong. But look at her. She is so cute. Look at her little self. And she tried to dress up her robe, you know? But you know, she's a little tipsy there in that picture.
In every picture.
So, and also keep in prayers, Bobby Christina Brown. She is still supposed. I guess she's still in the hospital. We haven't heard any updates on that. So we sending prayers out to her and the Brown and Houston family. And so, you know, that's just a really tragic situation there. And how people can, people think because you got money and your parents are famous and you think you're taking care of. Everybody struggles with something. Okay.
And so, sometimes being from a rich, well-known family is a worse curse than just
like
being...
Like Drew Barrymore. I mean, the Barrymores was all messed up. She said she raised herself and everything, so that's getting off to a different thing here. But, of course, this is Valentine's weekend, and the hit movie that is out this weekend is 50 Shades of Grey. Now, this was a book that was put out about 4 years ago, 3 years ago, and there's three novels regarding this series. It's about being dominant and submissive. And about different sexual acts, being chained up, whipped, tickled, blindfolded,
gagged,
stretched. I mean, I don't know. But, you know, we went to see the movie,
yesterday.
And it was packed, though. It was all kinds of people in there, age groups, races. Everybody was checking out 50 Shades of Grey. So, Taylor, what did you think about the movie?
I thought it was the worst movie I ever seen in my entire life. Wow. Well, maybe not the worst. I can't remember the worst. But it was, the dialogue to me was tired. The sex scenes, I mean, okay, he's spanking her. Okay, who of us hasn't got a little ass spank every now and again? So that wasn't so, well, I don't know, Wanda's looking like
not with no strap. I didn't get my ass beat with no strap. But
and who hasn't been tickled with a feather?
You can spank it.
And, you know, it just wasn't what I expected, I guess.
Well, the book, I read all three novels. The book was so much better, and I think the movie left out the meatiness of the book. The book went into why he was the way he was, and they really didn't show her in the movie as she started her own career. She was educated, and so it just left out a lot, but I'm hearing it might be a sequel.
I won't be seeing it. I'm sorry.
But you know what? I liked the richness of the movie, and I liked, if you're going to do that kind of stuff, I'd rather him be real rich and have his own
billionaire
separate room.
Right,
I don't
want to
be home and I look up after and see the shackles above my damn head. I mean, you ain't put that shit up. I don't want to see that after we did it. And, you know, hanging from the door, from the bathroom, or in the kitchen. You know, you go where your pots are hanging.
Ceiling falling in because you
went. Proper pots and stuff.
You in the local town.
I want a rich guy with the room being separate, but I will have limitations. I also saw myself being very intoxicated, and I couldn't be a good girl like he wanted because I can't keep my mouth shut. But
maybe you can be the dominant, and he can be
the
submissive.
I would love to be on the other end of that strip.
They got clubs out there.
You didn't clean up. You didn't clean up. I saw shoes in the hallway. The toilet seat was up.
She getting that too. Let me move down a little bit. Make it squatted over here.
You check it out. It is getting hot in here. It's getting hot in here. Woo. So anyway, Taylor Love Tells All. We have a busy schedule as usual. And
this month is almost over.
Yeah, it's almost over. Hurry up, spring. Saturday, February 21st, we're doing Married, Divorced, and the Blended Family. So,
you got the old schedule. We changed it. I'm sorry,
okay,
baby.
Well,
I think we're doing Black History. Oh, just tune in.
Well, that's the same thing.
We had Blended
Black History.
Marriage.
What will be our legacy? So that's what we're going to do on February 21st.
Right.
Tune in. And February 28th is Christian Brooks from Choppers. She's the CEO of DC Fashion Foundation. And she's going to be here and talk about the
Fashion Incubator.
Yep, Fashion
that
Incubator.
That she's doing with Macy's.
Yep, so tune in. There's a lot going on. And we're getting ready to sign off. Get out of here. Enjoy your Valentine's Day. Be careful of snow, bad weather, and all that good stuff. So,
and Wanda's gonna.
I'm heading down south. I'm going to Miami, going to South Beach. So look out for me.
She's gonna have her glasses on.
Okay, have my glasses on. That's how you gonna know me. So anywho,
all right, and again, well, thank
happy
you.
Happy Valentine's Day,
thank
Taylor.
You, baby. I love you.
Love you too.
Taylor Love Collection. Check out this is this piece is from the Taylor Love Collection, and it's the Young Love, and this one is Cold as Ice. She said, how I get that piece? Right. So Cold as Ice. But it's going to be on Usani House, USANII House.com. They're for sale. A portion of the proceeds are going to the American Heart Association. I created the line with my Aunt Vita Jackson in mind, who died of heart disease, and thought Valentine's Day would be a good day to launch it. So check out Usani House.com. It's only going to be there for a limited time, limited edition. So I want to wish you all a happy Valentine's Day. Love, peace, and soul.
And this is my Valentine. Rocky Ali, say hi to everybody. Happy Valentine's Day.
And we will see you guys next Saturday. Smooches.
They say I'm crazy, the way you got me open, baby. Ooh. They say I'm bugging, the way I'm time sweating your loving. Ooh. They all sit and wonder why this feeling I cannot hide. It ain't a question of pride.